My father's face is ashen, and his hands tremble as he lights one cigarette after another. I want to scream and scream. The next morning, headlines roar. We are liberated! Hitler's glorious army is in Budapest! All day long, the radio blares Deutschland über alles, and the country is agog with the news. 2 days late. 2 days late. News reaches us of Jews having been arrested in Budapest on the streets, on streetcars, at their workplaces, at railroad stations, and herded into freight trains. And the trains are chained shut. Where were they shipped? No one knows. Father stops pacing the floor. I cannot stand it any longer. There's a train at 8 p.m. I'm going to Budapest to bring Bobby home. It's too late. They'll arrest you too. You won't be able to help him. Stay here with us. God will be with us and save him. Mother's voice has a strange tremor. I hug her and she begins to cry openly. Father's tall, erect frame crumbles like a dry biscuit. God, if only Bubby were here. During the night, Bubby arrives from Budapest. Mr. Cardos does not return. Neither does his son, Yuri. They are shipped off in freight trains. They become our first casualties of the Holocaust, together with all the boys and girls of our town who studied in Budapest. They were all taken away from the beautiful Hungarian capital in trains chained shut to an unknown destination. Budapest, the city of my dreams, has become the anteroom of Auschwitz.